joy to the world. This then is the culmination of our waiting. We have lit the candles of hope, of peace, of love. In the glow of their light, we feel the warmth of deep and quiet joy. Joy to the earth, the Savior reigns. Let music be raised in the name of Christ, who offers us hope in the midst of despair, peace in the chaos of life, and God's love graciously, silently, vulnerably offers. And heaven and nature sing. And so in the spirit of the joy of the season, let's take a moment, greet one another as brothers and sisters in Christ, within our household groups, however you would so choose, in others, wave, bow, peace sign, thumbs up, however you would so choose.
Many years.
And then you all can sit down.
I know.
But glad to see so many of you here today for our kids' Christmas program Sunday. So we're almost to the end of December. That means the January-February devotional booklets are out. And you know, we still got, what, today's the 20th, so we still got 11 days worth in the November-December ones. So they're out there in the table, in the entryway, fancy church word narthex. So feel free to grab those for yourself or others that you think might enjoy them. As I say, they do us no good sitting here gathering dust. So Christmas Eve is 4 days away. I actually had someone this last week, and they were being serious, and they said, what's the date of Christmas Eve this year? Now, I'm used to people saying, what day does Christmas Eve fall on, or what day, but the question was, what's the date of Christmas Eve this year? You know, I think it's December 24th. Did I get that right? Yeah, okay. And they said, and when is that? And I thought, okay, so that's what you really wanted to know. Thursday. Ah, okay. So Thursday evening, we will be having a Christmas Eve service here. We'll have some recorded music. We'll have two live songs, solo, men's trio. And then if the weather prognosticators are correct, there is no blizzard in the forecast for Christmas Eve. It's going to be a mite nippy. They're saying that the lows will get down into the teens. So by the time we're finishing the service, it could be that chilly. So bring a good heavy coat, because we will be having our battery-operated candles, which can't be blown out, even if there's a bit of a breeze outside. And the plan is, at the end of the service, we bundle up, we head outside, we distance, and we sing Silent Night together to bring Christmas Eve to a close. So plan on being chilly for a little bit, because Linda said, oh, and we're just going to sing one verse. I said, no, Silent Night. You got to sing all three. And no, you don't need to know the lyrics, because on the back of the order of service will be the lyrics, and you'll be able to see it by your electric candle. So it's all good. So hope to see you here on Christmas Eve. Any other announcements, things going on that people need to be aware of?
Before you leave today, there is a little goodie bag back there in front of Leta. Please take that. anyone that is 18 or under, please see me before you leave church.
Okay, that's not me.
No, you can still see me, but...
I'm coming up on my Route 66 birthday in January, so... Okay, so if you're under 18, make sure...
18 or under.
18 or under. So see Carol, and goodie bags back there. Is that for the older children of God, or the younger children of God, or...
It's for all the children.
It's for all the children of God. I like that. You know, we're the UCC, inclusive, right? Yes, there we go. All right. Anything else need to be announced?
Some little person here celebrated her 8th birthday on Friday.
Ooh, all right. Congratulations, Tisha. Yeah. 8 going on 22, right? No? She says, no, don't do that to me. Any other announcements? And any anniversaries going on? All right, so we're all still married and only one little girl got older, so ooh, it's a good day. So today is the kids' Christmas program. Today we lit the candle of joy. It was a no-brainer what our opening carol is today. And I found a wonderful CD. All the carols you hear sung today are sung by children.
Tisha, RJ, Karlee, all kids, come on in. The cookies are ready. Can you kids tell tell me what you want for Christmas. Tomorrow, I am going shopping, and I want to get some stuff on the way.
I want a fancy new cell phone, a puppy, my new Xbox game.
I couldn't hear you, Tisha. I'm sorry.
A new game, and maybe a trip to Disney.
Wow! That sounds like a really big list, Tisha. I am not sure if your dad and I can afford to do all of those things.
I know what I want. I would like a new Ford F-350. I really can use the manual transmission because I think shifting is really fun. You might want to throw in some new big rims and wheels, and I need a better sound system so I can really feel the sound of the day. Also, all my friends have 65-inch TVs in their bedroom, so I'll need one of those.
Well, RJ, it sounds like you have it all planned out. I thought your dad and I were going to give you our old Ford Pinto to get 50 miles to the gallon. I thought maybe you kids would have, like, clothing or other necessities on your list.
Well, Mom, I want some new, like, maybe some golden heels and some Nike clothing. I also want some other things that I don't really need, like a new walk-in closet that I could turn into a shisha. Cheryl called State Farm because she thought someone lit her shisha on fire, and then she said that her shisha was struck by lightning.
You
maybe not.
So you're thinking maybe a she shed closet? Maybe a geez, you guys are all full of the Christmas spirit, but in different ways. Sometimes people ask what others want just to clarify a few things or get some ideas, but aren't expecting a huge list like a $85,000 new truck. Life is about so much more. I guess I need to get you all involved in the Christmas spirit with Operation Christmas Child, where we help a church pack shoeboxes for little kids all over the world. We are all going shopping tomorrow. You all are going to pick out small items that can easily fit in a shoebox, and then we're going to pack them up for the children who are only getting that one box for Christmas. Well, that's enough, everyone. Sit up and straighten up, and you'll all get nothing for Christmas. Just in case you didn't already know, Christmas is about Jesus and his birth. It started off as a celebration of life, and now is a big joke of who can get the best present. Maybe our pastor Kurt can give you a scripture or a small sermon on what this holiday represents to us. Now off to bed.
From the hand and heart of the Apostle Paul to the church in Corinth, we have these words. Each of you must give as you have made up your mind, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to provide you with every blessing in abundance, so that by always having enough of everything, you may share abundantly in every good work. May all of God's children hear these words and know that this, indeed, is the spirit of Christmas.
Kids, wake up! It's time to go shopping! all got your coats on already. Well, everyone, let's go shopping.
Talk amongst yourself.
Maybe they can use some light.
Okay.
Just knock on the door and see what happens.
Just make it a little louder.
Maybe they really did go shopping.
Wow, what a busy day. Oh, jeez.
Suggestion is whatever young person is speaking, grab the microphone.
RJ, what did you get in your shoebox?
I got lots of stuff. I never knew that a clothespin, rubber band, a box of playing cards, or a rag would be anything I would ever want for Christmas. I guess if I didn't have anything else, I would use the rubber band to make a slingshot, or clothespin could be used for a pinching game with your sister. I would miss my Xbox, but maybe I would adjust. I need to take everything in this shoebox and see what I can make of it.
That's an awesome idea, RJ. I would like all of you now to keep that shoebox and imagine it is the only thing you're getting all year. I will go shopping this weekend to replace what you bought and more. Because that box in front of you is what you're getting for Christmas.
Hey, Mom, I think I could invite some friends over. Instead of playing the Xbox, we could use a plastic spoon out of my box to see if we can run across the room with an egg and see if it doesn't fall off. And we could use a plastic fork and spoon to play knights or hunting spears.
Wow, Mom, that sounds really rough to receive one little box. I would have to live without designer brand name, special, or any item that you even asked for. I can't imagine living like that. Are we still going to get other presents for Christmas, or are we only going to get that one shoebox?
We are going to give you guys some presents. We are for sure not giving you all brand new full-size trucks. We are also all going to help pack shoe boxes this year at the church and then track some of them to see where they went. Then we can imagine how that item would help out a third grade boy from Panama that has a hut for a house.
That sounds really nice, Mom. I am really excited, and I will try to imagine how it would feel to only receive one box.
Thanks, Mom, for all your help. I remember that Christmas is about the gift of a baby to Mary and Joseph and not the gift of a truck.
Now it's off to bed and say your prayers. All children, let's lay your shoeboxes down, and we're going to say a little prayer over these boxes, okay? Everybody bow your heads. Lord in heaven.